caterpillars are baby butterflies or moths before they become adults. They kind of look like little worms with lots of legs.
Caterpillars have tiny feet called prolegs that help them crawl and cling to leaves and branches. And some have as many as 10 legs.
And caterpillars typically have 6 true legs near their head, plus several stumpy prolegs toward the rear of their body with tiny hooks that help the caterpillar grip onto surfaces as it moves around.
Caterpillars don't have lungs like humans do. Instead, they breathe through tiny pores called spiracles along the sides of their body segments.
Spiracles are little holes lined up in a row along each side of their body.
The spiracles open and close to let air in and out as a caterpillar moves.
And let me tell you something, they eat a lot. Caterpillars are like little eating machines, and they munch on plant leaves all day long to help them grow bigger.
Some caterpillars, like monarch caterpillars, travel very long distances to find the right plants to eat.
While most caterpillars munch on leaves, some like to eat different things. There are even caterpillars that eat honeycomb from beehives, or even wool from sweaters.
Some caterpillars are very colorful with bright stripes or spikes.
Bright stripes? And spikes?
Yeah.
Am I a caterpillar?
Oh my... Oh.
Do I finally know what I am?
No, no.
Let me try to fly!
Well, Gus, caterpillars don't fly until they turn into either a butterfly or a moth. Anyway, these colors and patterns help to protect caterpillars from birds and other predators that want to eat them.
Some caterpillars can make funny clicking noises or even spit out yucky liquid to scare away birds and animals that want to eat them. Gross, but smart.
Caterpillars are also very bendy and soft since they don't have any bones inside their body. Their bodies are kind of squishy.
As caterpillars get bigger, their skin gets too tight, so they molt or shed their outer skin, kind of like how you outgrow your clothes.
So the question is, how does a caterpillar turn into a moth or butterfly?
First, when a caterpillar is all done eating lots and lots of leaves and has grown very big, it stops crawling around.
Instead, it finds a safe spot on a twig or stem and gets itself stuck there with a special silk thread that it makes.
Next, something weird happens inside the caterpillar's body. It releases some funky juice that turns all of its caterpillar parts to mush or soup on the inside.
Then the caterpillar does one last cool trick. It does a wiggle and sheds its outer skin, leaving behind a hard shell called a chrysalis.
This chrysalis acts like a little home where the caterpillar can hide.
And inside this chrysalis shell, the caterpillar soup reorganizes through an amazing process called metamorphosis.
While inside the chrysalis house, the mushy caterpillar soup magically reorganizes and rebuilds itself into a brand new creature.
Arms, legs, eyes, wings, and all slowly form over a few weeks or months.
Eventually, depending on the caterpillar, a moth or a butterfly will come out and begin to fly around.
And here's one last cool fact for you. The biggest, longest caterpillar in the world is over 6 inches long. Now that's one giant caterpillar.
Well, hey, guess what? Now we all know just a little bit more about caterpillars.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to smash that thumbs up button. It really helps out our channel.
It sure does.
Make sure you subscribe.
Bye.
Bye.